So Rafi and Glee recently posted a video addressing fears about your art ending up in a thrift store and how many people feel shame and rejection when that happens. It's probably rooted in the same shame that people feel when we donate gifts that we never really use, afraid that our friends will find out and feel rejected by it. So how do you think you would feel if your art ended up in a thrift store? If you've been hanging out with me for a very long time, you might remember that my art did end up in a thrift store. My very first sale on Etsy was a very simple watercolor of a bird carrying a piece of garland, and the supplies were all student quality, and so they were very pale, not very much color building going on. My photos of it were terrible. I'm pretty sure that I sold it for like $10, and then I shipped it, and then I forgot about it. And then one day I got a phone call from a man in New York explaining that he found my painting in a thrift store and wanted to know how much it was worth. And there were a lot of feelings, okay. First, for being put on the spot for having to estimate a price for this thing. And this might have been back in the day when I was just charging for materials and time, so like there was no business profit in there. So I felt a little shame having to tell him that I was just, you know, like a regular restaurant worker and none of my paintings were really worth anything. And yeah, I felt a tinge of embarrassment of my art ending up in a thrift store because it meant at some point whoever had it before didn't like it anymore. And I did feel a little rejected and a little embarrassed that it would happen so publicly, you know. When you see something in the thrift store, you know that somebody just didn't like it anymore. So it's, yeah, that's a little embarrassing. But in this case, I was just so thrilled that a phone call came from so far away and from such an interesting place. You know what I mean? Like, wow, New York. It's kind of like art central, right? Like sending my old piece to a thrift store meant that someone else picked it up and learned of my existence as an artist, which was kind of a bonus. I do have some small pieces that have aged out of affection, but I never really thought about thrifting them on purpose as an actual marketing strategy before. I don't really feel proud of that specific bird painting in an aesthetic, skilled kind of way, but that exhilaration of being accidentally connected with somebody on the other side of the whole entire continent technically left nothing but positive feelings around that memory. And if you do want to hear more about how people feel about their art in thrift stores in particular, I will leave a link to that video in the description. But how do you think that you would feel? I personally would prefer just not to know, but I can think of worse things that could happen to them. One thing that I struggle a lot with art practice is the environmental footprint. I mean, like, I work with small pieces of paper, watercolors, like nothing too chemical. I don't use too many plastics or like paint thinners or oils or anything like that. And I'm also just kind of hyper aware of the strange human trait we have of producing trash everywhere we go. We just make so much stuff, even though no other animal kind of does that. And so I do often worry about where my paintings will end up in the long term. I mean, maybe someone will paint something cool on top of it for a YouTube video, or they'll cut them up for collage or decoration. Maybe it will be recycled into something useful. Those things sound totally fine to me. I worry more that a painting will be just in a trash pile somewhere leaking toxic pigments into the groundwater, or it just becomes another object in a closet that someone feels too guilty to do anything with it. Or it shows up as an icon for a Bitcoin scam, or put on a racist flag or something, I don't know. There's so many possibilities that scare me away from making art sometimes. And just saying like, oh, it's just something humans do, making trash, it's not really that comforting. And so there's so many different types of artists and ways that people approach this kind of thing, how people feel about it. Me, I'm quite comfortable with just making art and letting it go, like selling it or giving it as gifts and stuff. It feels good to me to just let things go. And other people don't like to let things go. I met another artist at the market recently who says that he gets angry when he visits a friend and sees his artwork just sitting in a storage room. Like, he said he would literally steal it back when they're not looking because he can't stand to see his pieces not receive the love and attention that they deserve, which I think is kind of funny. Yeah, I'm almost on the way other end of the spectrum where I just want to be able to make things like while I can. Even if I end up gone and forgotten entirely and my art doesn't exist after I'm gone, like that's okay to me. Other artists don't even sell their work because they're so attached to it. And others, like I said, have really passionate and unspoken conditions about where their art goes. And some people hope that they'll be famous and that their art will becoming a priceless artifact that, you know, rich men will pass back and forth forever. I'm really curious to know, like, where on the spectrum are you? Do you want your paintings to survive forever or get recycled or turned into something else? I don't know. How do you feel about where your art might end up? I hope I didn't give anyone an existential crisis. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.